anecdote related to his song.
By doing this, he is able to motivate you guys, young adults, with the message and theme behind the anecdote.
Please stick around to the end to answer the survey related to the concert. Raphael will remind you guys before the master song.
The set list is as follows.
Master of Puppets by Metallica.
By Megadeth.
Fire with Fire by Metallica.
The Spirit Carries On by Dream Theater.
Sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
Thank you. song 3 years ago. I was blown away at how gigantic the song was. It started with this full-blown, speedy-like riffs, with a melodic and melancholy middle section followed by, you know, a gigantic grand finale. It was filled with a lot of emotion and anger, and I loved it, you know, as a middle schooler. But after hearing it the first time, you know, I turned around from my computer screen because I was scared my parents would think I'm like turning demonic or something like that. But little did I know, Master of Puppets was made in their generation, and when I told them about it, they laughed it off. Since then, I love this song to death. Obviously, I wanted to try and play it, so I practiced 4 or 5 times a day, 7 days a week, and most of the time it only consisted of me of opening a metronome and website and down picking like this. Like 212 beats per minute, because that's what the song was. And it was a painfully slow process, but I kept going because the only thing in my head was, I want to play this, I want to beat these guys, I want to beat the creators that, you know, created the really cool riff. It sounded so cool. Slowly but gradually, I showed improvement. It took me 1 month to show any progress, but when it did, it happened, and I was the happiest guy on the planet. I used that feeling and turned it into motivation to improve my endurance and downpicking, because I needed to play this song for 8 minutes, minus the middle section. This song, I think, was the third song I played from start to finish. My first song being Brainstew by Green Day, to get the basic chord down, and then followed by For Whom the Bell Tolls, and then 3 years ago, which is Master of Puppets by Metallica. The message and theme I'm trying to tell you guys here is never give up and persevere, because you'll achieve what you want to achieve. There was never a moment where I said, I want to give up and, you know, I can't do this and I'll do this next time. I always try to aim higher, because you'll achieve higher than your expectations if you do that. And if you truly want to achieve something big, it will happen. It might take weeks, months, years, even decades. This next song is Holy Wars, The Punishment Due by Megadeth. Mustaine, the frontman of Megadeth. There's a former member of Metallica that got kicked out due to his excessive drinking habits. And while Metallica continued to create a whole new genre and develop their sound, Dave Mustaine was left filled with rage and fury. He got to seek revenge and formed his own band. With the help of bassist David Ellison, they were able to find fusion jazz musicians Chris Poland and drummer Garl Samuelson. The quartet went on for world domination and even went faster and heavier than Metallica. With all the success and a huge underground following, Dave Mustaine was still not satisfied with his Megadeth success. After several lineup changes, Dave Mustaine was able to acquire neoclassical metal guitarist Marty Friedman and jazz drummer Nick Menta. They went on to create an album titled Rust in Peace that left a huge mark on history and ultimately a strong contender against Metallica's Master of Puppets album. When I first heard this song, I was able to capture all Dave Mustaine's anger and fury through this title opener because I was able to relate to this. 3 years ago, I was a bassist playing in a cover band titled Raw Joys with my friends. We all enjoyed each other's company and loved playing music together, but as time went on, we started to become sloppy. Conflicts soon arose, and one day I snapped and told my frontman, "How hard is it to play chords and sing the song?" The song we were currently practicing at that time was Bullet with Butterfly Wings by the Smashing Pumpkins. He responded with, "Why don't you try playing guitar for a change and see what it's like?" The only thing I had running through my mind for the next few days was, do I want to prove him wrong and leave my band behind, or apologize and continue to play with them and enjoy our hangouts? Back then, it was the hardest dilemma of my life since I knew these guys since third grade. I don't know if I chose the right answer, but now I'm confident enough to say otherwise. The message or moral of the story is to stay true to you, to who you are. Don't follow what others want, because we are all unique and different in our own ways. Your friends aren't always going to agree with you, and you don't always have to agree with them too. We all apologize to each other, and we all are still great friends playing online video games together. The breakup of our band was an important and crucial lesson, not just to me, but for the rest of the band members, as it will help choose us the path we want and not what others want. This next clip, sorry. This next song is Fight Fire with Fire by Metallica. We'll be right back. Before we go to the last song, I think Alicia would like to advertise her BB after school. So please come up to stage. Alicia.
Gallery. You can see it in the theater foyer next to the ATM. Today it will be open until 4 o'clock. I might be able to extend it a little, so just make sure to check it out. Thank you!
The poster will be after this, so the next slide. So please support her, guys. And, before we also go to the last one, I guess. I would like you guys to fill out my survey, which is with this link right here. It's just to show me what I need to improve on, and I guess it's just the basic questions about did I achieve my goal or not. So yeah, that's okay. So please take your time, guys, and you guys can take out your phones and yeah, take a photo for him right now, I guess. Okay. This next song is dedicated to a man that has always been throughout my journey as a musician and has always supported me even when others discouraged me. I didn't really have a satisfactory bond with him, but 3 years ago when I first discovered Metallica, the gap started to disappear and I was able to be more confident and more open about myself to him. He's always been involved in all my musical endeavors, from playing in my old school's ensemble, watching my old band Raw Joy play live, and finally right here, watching my solo performance. He watched all of them from beginning to end. That man is no other than my father, which is supposed to be sitting right there, but... Oh, hello. I'm very fortunate to have a parent who is very passionate and supportive of my interest. He has saved my career as a guitarist 2 years ago when I was burned out from playing too much. He bought me a 7-string guitar because I was interested in a band called Trivium, and some of their songs required that low B string. After jamming out constantly with the 7-string, Trivium opened a whole new world for me. I started to listen to new bands like Iron Maiden, In Flames, Venom, Death, Yngwie, Malmsteen, Paul Gilbert, and many more. My dad single-handedly saved me from not ever picking up the guitar again just by buying me a 7-string. He has also taught me knowledge about the guitar out of the theory. Things like what types of pickups I should use, passive or active, how do I switch out my pickups, what are differences between a set neck and a bolt-on neck, what should my signal chain consist of? The list just goes on and on. There's a particular moment where my dad helped me found my passion for physics. I wasn't doing too well when it came to stoichiometry because chemistry wasn't my thing. But when I started to learn things like heat transfer, latent heat of fusion, potential energy, kinetic energy, everything just clicked in my mind. I was very boastful about my science grades towards my parents because it was a subject where I was having fun and learning about new things. The moral message of this anecdote is really to value our parents. All of us are fortunate enough to be able to study and work together in this prosperous school. And it's all thanks to our parents' efforts. This next song is one of my dad's favorites, and he told me to do him a favor and play the song live because he loved the melody and the overall tone of the song. This next song is a question every one of us has dealt with at one point or another, and we continue to ask it. It is, what are we doing here? What is this thing called life, this consciousness? It's a mystery, and I think this song's lyrics say the best. It's laid out for us, it gives us hope, and brings us all that we do to continue, and we do go on. So I want you all to sing it, and I want you to believe it. This is the spirit that carries on.
The here and the now, and you're only given one. tomorrow I'd be alright, because I believe that after we're gone, the spirit carries on.
you to a project performance. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And until next time.